Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to compress an existing PDF document using the syncfusion.net PDF library. In this video, I will show you how to create a .NET console application in Visual Studio and add the syncfusion PDF library to it. I will also demonstrate how to compress an existing PDF document. I open Visual Studio 2022 and create a new project. From the list of project templates, I select the console app and name the project Compress PDF Sample. Then, I continue with the default target framework and click the Create button. Now, my application is ready to use. Next, I need to add the PDF library by installing the syncfusion PDF package. So, I open the NuGet Package Manager. In the Browse tab, I search for the syncfusion PDF Imaging Netcore NuGet package. And install it in my application. The package is installed successfully. Here, I need to register a valid trial license key. So, I open the program.cs file and register a license key using the register license method. To know where to generate this license key, refer to the link in the description. Now, I am going to compress an existing PDF document using the syncfusion PDF library. I add the necessary namespaces like syncfusion PDF. And syncfusion PDF parsing to compress the PDF file. I retrieve the PDF file location and read it as a file stream from the specified location. Then, I create an instance of the PDF loaded document class and initialize it with the file stream object. I create an instance for the PDF Compression Options class to specify various options for compressing PDF files. First, I will compress the images in the PDF document, so let me set Compress Image property to true. After that, I set the image quality to 50, which will be used during the compression process. Next, set the optimize font property to true, which reduces the font file size by removing all the unused glyph data. Then, set the optimize page contents property to true to remove unwanted commented lines, white spaces, and compress all uncompressed contents. I set the remove metadata property to true to remove any metadata from the PDF document. Finally, assign the compression options to the PDF document using the compress method. I create an output file stream by saving the output PDF document. And save the document to the stream. Then, I will call the close method to dispose all the memory consumed by PDF DOM as well as disposes its document stream. Now, let me save the changes and run the application. Look here, the original file size is 467 kilobytes. When I save the document, the saved PDF file will typically have a smaller file size than the original document. When I open the PDF file after compression, you should be able to see the same content as the original document. Let me recap what I have shown so far. I showed you how to create a .NET console application in Visual Studio. I also showed you how to compress an existing PDF document using the SyncFusion PDF library. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our .NET products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.